go ahead and get this thing rolling. We got some poetry in the building tonight. Let's give it up for poetry, spoken word. Great time. So we're gonna go ahead and bring our first artist up for this evening. We got none other than a smooth brother that goes by the name Poet Pimp. Let's give it up for Poet Pimp. Y'all make sure y'all showing love. Y'all having fun. Again, celebrating beautiful young lady's birthday. Let's make sure we enjoy ourselves. All right.
Burning bridges. Aaliyah doesn't give a damn, but cares and shares the love in the air. Us Leos, we speak our minds, but keep it buried. A Leo doesn't have to hide, nor does a Leo find life in a lie. And for those two reasons, a Leo is love and hate. But a Leo knows how to shake the depressed hatred and make it.
Come on now.
A Leo is unique. When a Leo falls, I don't panic. I manage, get back to my feet, and continue to be unique. A Leo is always mugged. Therefore, a Leo's life will always be overrated and judged. Us Leos, we know our worth. If you fuck with the Leo's testosterone, know that your feelings will get hurt. A Leo is not perfect, but the trials and tribulations a Leo takes you through may be worth it.
Come on now.
Ladies and gentlemen, I said us Leos are not perfect, but the words a Leo speaks to you and the lessons a Leo is teaching you will be worth it. This world needs a Leo's strength,
come on,
guidance, and love to breathe, and succeed. So dreams will become reality, and reality will be seen. If you's a Leo, you know of a Leo, then you're feeling me. Huh. Peace, poetry, and parenting.
All right, thank
y'all. Got a couple.
Yes.
Got a couple more pieces for y'all. I would like to give homage to my poetic sister and also my Leo queen. Man, this is Leo season. I'm gonna tell y'all like this. If y'all don't have Leo season in your kitchen, your life will be tasteless. Yeah.
I like that.
So I'm gonna get into the next piece. Matter of fact, let me get y'all participating. I'm gonna give y'all two titles of poems that I wrote, and I want y'all to pick the one that touches your nerve.
Okay.
The first title is Simone. The second title is Burning Bridges.
Ooh, I like Burning Bridges.
Burning Bridges.
You sound good.
Okay, all right.
I like Burning Bridges.
So keep this in mind. As far as me and my poetic pimping literature is concerned, we will attract a strong mind or offend a weak nerve.
Uh-oh.
Now, after I do this piece, some of y'all might refer me as Pastor Poet Pimp. Because I'm about to preach to y'all. Burning bridges. Sometimes burning bridges isn't a bad thing. It prevents us from going to places we should have never been to begin with. Burning bridges is a lesson blended with blessings. Blessings blended with lessons. Lessons, blessings blended with the message. Throughout our course of living, we place ourselves in situations that make us stronger or break us down. Some bridges we make it across. We have no choice but to turn our backs, walk away proud, while that bridge burns to the ground. Cement Crosby 10 to extend, because we know that bridge will appreciate the creativity that we have at hand.
All right.
Brothers, our habits, places, peoples, or things, someday, some way, we have to burn that bridge. Learn and forgive. Especially if that bridge is distracting us from building that extended bridge that has no intention of giving in. Every now and again, we have to take the cotton out of our ears and put it in our mouth. Meaning, listen more and talk less. And recognize when God wants you to cross that bridge to live at your best. Recognize it when God needs you to cross that bridge and have uncommon faith in what you invest.
Okay.
Now the bridge you're on may sway. Don't do something permanently stupid because you're temporarily upset. Some bridges are built in our lives for success. All bridges will give us unexpected tests we haven't even studied for yet.
Come on, this is good.
Now the bridge you set on fire may be unable to burn. I'm going to tell you what you can do. Go to Lowe's or Home Depot and buy you some tools and loosen the bolt on that bridge day by day. Hell, I even got tired of doing that. So let me take you back to when I said have an uncommon faith in what you invest. Now invest in some C4 and blow that bridge to smithereens. While the pieces sink to the bottom of the sea, we have to be prudent the next time that bridge is seen. Burning, building, even blowing up bridges will provide your life with faith, favor, confirmation, joy, poetic, pimp, literature, peace, poetry, and pimp.
All right.
Yeah. Okay, I got one more that I'm undecided really on this one.
Speak to us.
Got her face or so vicious.
So delicious.
So delicious.
Wait.
What's the option?
Her face or so delicious.
So delicious.
Okay, so delicious it is. Now, I'm about to talk to y'all queens tonight. And I'm gonna need y'all assistance too as well. Let me start with the ethereal hips and the joyful essence of your soft, thick thighs. Staring into those beautiful bedroom eyes reveals what's on your creative mind. You're in need of a king who will spend some quality time. He won't disguise lies with lies, respecting your morals, knowing there's more to you than just hips and thighs. You're an exquisite, incredible queen with a solicitous mind. You're pleasing to a king's taste. So delicious in many ways. Even a blind man can stand next to you and feel that you are a blessing. Brightening every day, making living feel more heavenly. You give respect, so you expect nothing less with common sense and common respect. When it all boils down, you hold your own common ground. You're so delicious. Very soulicious. All the soulicious queens in the building, do one favor for this poet pimp. Stand to your feet. And if you're not standing to your feet, I'm going to assume you consider yourself to be a princess. Okay. Let me get back to your soulicious mind. Your beautiful bedroom eyes, your hips and thine. The way you walk with the God, the way you live your life with pride. You get what you need until you're satisfied. Y'all don't believe in playing with emotions because y'all don't like for y'all emotions to be played with at any time. So all the soldiers and queens are standing to your feet. Do one more favor for this poking pimp. Keep up the good work on keeping yourself so delicious. Peace. Poetry.
And pimping.
Thank y'all again for that. Real quick while you're up the stage and maybe I know I got some more for y'all. Y'all wanna hear some more, I'll come back and do something later. But feel free to follow me on Instagram under Poet Pimp. Not Poetic Pimp, not Poet the Pimp, but Poet Pimp. I also have a YouTube and a Facebook, which is Jerome Expressions, where you will experience the peer as an other expression. Man, y'all just enjoy the rest of y'all night. Drink responsibly, and by all means, get home safely. Once again, peace, poetry, and pen. Thank y'all.
All right, y'all give me a call. Good brother to him. All right, poor pimp. Again, we still celebrating for, again, a beautiful queen's 30-year celebration. So make sure y'all show her some love and continue, like poor pimp said, drink responsibly. So we're going to do it all night long and have us a good time. But we got some more wonderful poetry coming to the stage. None other than the queen birthday lady herself coming up here to bless this stage, bless this mic. So y'all make sure y'all show us some love. We got the queen Gina coming up.
Hey guys, I'm grown now. First, I just want to say thank y'all so much for coming out. I really love the intimacy with my family being here. I know I invited a few other people that couldn't make it. And it's okay because everybody that came, I feel like is supposed to be here. And I just can't tell y'all enough how much I appreciate y'all. So just before I start, since there's not any other poets here, I'm going to just take advantage to just give y'all a little peace. But y'all already know I was in church for a long time and I kind of got a little hurt by the church and I haven't been doing my music or poetry or anything. So because I was turning 30, you know, it was really important for me to actually do something with my gift that I know God put inside me, which is the reason why I wanted to do this and make it special. So Pimp, Poet Pimp, you are the amazing. Can y'all just give it up for him one more time? You really taught us some stuff on tonight, and I just, y'all, burning bridges thing. Y'all know I had to burn a bunch of bridges in my life. Lord Jesus, forgive me for everything that I burned. This is love. So anyway, let me just get on into it. I hear a graveyard whisper my name, and with shame I feel dismayed because somehow I turned around and whispered, hey. But yet these dry bones don't fuel the bones that we had when we were young. Oh, how we seek to find a bone that can never grow old but last long. A bone so strong you would die to hold on. A cliff that would constantly have you falling until you rest in peace at its tombstone. These dry bones, will they ever live again? Will they ever breathe again? They are as dry as the dust, and there's something that still trusts that they can breathe one more time. They can learn one more time, believe one more time, but how? I'm talking dry as the cotton growing in your mouth, dry as a single woman longing for a spouse, dry as that smile you force out daily. But just maybe they can breathe again. Maybe those eye sockets can see again, envision those visions really clear again. Maybe that skull can still paint pictures in a dry place. Maybe that rib can page can still catch a heart race. It's never too late to fascinate yourself with your dreams. Though oftentimes it seems we have to neglect what we want to get what we think we need. Locked up in a clock-in jail cell, we seem to rest our heads here with the mindset of stack that paper. Yet this clock-in jail cell was never intended for you to post bail here, so you stay there, confined to compromising your time instead of working on rhymes you're doing overtime. That rent won't pay itself, and these rhymes get you some help, so you stay there. Stuck in a mindset of stacking that paper, it turns to water vapor. Things you can do without are now being catered. You rot in a place called comfortability, then you lose the very sight you need to lead. Working your finger to the bone just to take care of home, but not once have you remembered the throne. So I was neglecting my destiny, trying to feed what's left of me, these dry bones. Then he spoke to me. He said, prophesy over these bones and say to them, dry bones, you shall live. Your finances shall live. Your hopes and desires shall live. As I sat at the desk in my kitchen, I envisioned bones coming back to life. And it finally hit me, y'all. These 30-year-old bones can live again. Thank y'all so much. I got one more piece that I don't think anybody in this room except maybe one person has heard before. And I had another poet that was supposed to come out, but she didn't. So after this, if anybody would like to say anything, great. If not, then we are pretty much done. But I do want to hit y'all. And I thank y'all for coming out. I know y'all been here for a long ass time. And I support y'all so much. Y'all have no idea. Thank you so much, Robert, Nikki. I'm so sorry. I forgot your name, but you're the bomb. Can we start the track whenever you're ready? Yes. Take your time. And a little public disclaimer. This is for only mama. Just wanted to get your ears prepared because it's a little vulgar. You know, I don't ever cuss around my mama, but you know what I'm saying? You know, she wanted to come out, so I had to just make sure. But while they're getting that together, y'all, make sure y'all get y'all some coffee. You know what I'm saying? Stay away from the alcohol. But if you do get some alcohol, make sure you wait an hour after you drink before you drive so that you don't get a DWI, okay? Because that's
not cut a card for your own head.
Here we go, y'all.
So you think too much, you overthink. It's like, you kind of caught up in your own head. So you think too much, you overthink. And you let this shit come easy. So it'll be breezy, dog.
Situations keep breaking you, telling you you were gone. Now you sitting home with your head down, you alone. You don't really talk too much, you paint your pictures in vivid mind. You thinking you ain't got it, but you really hit it with time. You sit back, you watching your environment. You ask who that gets you tripping, cause you silent with any nigga approach you, you looking suspect. And I don't really gotta tell you, cause they give you respect, you see? You see you chilling in your mindset. Talk too much to yourself, that's gonna make you calm. Threat will work your worst enemy. So get a ball up in the media and tell them to post it. Shit, you ain't know what you do is proud, but even what you say. They be looking at you crazy, but you know you hit a day. You hear that work, you hear that knocking in your head. Get up from that freestyle and get up out your bed, see it? And you don't put shit on paper. You get up on the rhyme, sit in the vapor. But then you sit back and you question yourself, like, why I didn't put that shit out? Is that potential won't help? I need it. But you don't think anybody gonna help you, though. So you fall back. And I feel you, brother.
But G, the VP's ex speaking free preachment. I don't really gotta get up on the mic and preach, cause you know I speak. When I hit that mic, it hit that beat. So I let it bleed all up on the track like it's IV. Who you see? That's that RIP. I ain't got a gato. Put myself on the line, call me Mrs. Lotto. And I ain't reaching for no bottle. I'm setting my mindset. My only mission is the bottle. I gotta go full force. Might hit the blunt. Might just sit back and go write some shit and tell you a story. I might just tell you a story. Might just tell you a lead. Might just tell you something to help me get my mind off that ease and bleed. I'ma bleed up on the track to this bleed. Matter of fact, I ain't gonna stop bleeding until I lay it flat. Lot up on the track, you see me giving it back. That's why I get up on the mic and I ain't having a jack. Cause these hoes is wet. They talk shit behind your face. Really won't face you. All these hoes basic and I'm squared up. I'm squared off and I'm getting into my zone. Talking all that bullshit, left that pistol at home. I'm glad. I swear to God, pop that day, bro. Mama said, don't keep it on you. Thank you, Mama. We made it. I don't care no more. But see, I got some pistol in my grip and in my tongue. I let it go. Bitchy locking, they don't got none. I'm telling you, son. See, I've been covered by the blood. They looking scared. Like, did you really wanna rush? Did you wanna rush? Did you wanna really take your time and sit back for rhyme? Every relationship that's in time, it fell off. You was going too hard and it went soft. Now it's time to fall back and just get up on your boss, bitch. Shit. Fuck these hoes, bro. Go get your bread. Bread money. Yeah. Be easy. Thank y'all so much. I appreciate y'all for coming out. And y'all have an amazing night.
Y'all give it up for the birthday girl again. Blessing us with her gift on her birthday. You know what I'm saying? We appreciate you so much for sharing that with us. And again, happy birthday to the beautiful queen, to the beautiful young lady here celebrating with her family, her friends. So grateful that all of you could come. We're gonna put some music on and y'all stick around. Get y'all coffee, get y'all cocktails, get y'all groove on, and make sure y'all still showing y'all girls some expressions of love, the monetary kind. You know what I'm saying? And y'all just have a good, good night. Oh, baby, can I get some music?
You ready to say something to the people now?
It was wonderful.
Fantastic.
Lovely day. I just went down there.
I had a wonderful time. I enjoyed your gift. You are awesome artists. I am impressed. I love you. I can't wait to hear more from you. I'm going to follow you on Instagram once I learn how to do Instagram, but I will follow you on Facebook. I was blessed tonight. And happy birthday to my baby girl, my Cela girl, Brandy Antoinette Mickey.
Can I get a happy birthday too?
Is your birthday too?
It's Leo season, so it is my birthday.
Happy birthday. When was your birthday?
The 28th of July.
Happy birthday.
Really?
Oh, that's the exact day.
Yeah. I think this is the first time I met an actual Leo where we share the same day, birthday.
Really?
Yeah. It's my first time. Man, oh yeah, this is going to be amazing.
You know, y'all have this.
Yeah, we don't give up for nothing. You gotta kill it for us to give up.
I love the burning bridges. I recorded that. I love that so much. I'm that unburned bridge.
Okay. I think everybody in the world burning some bridges and building some.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. So what I'm gonna do, I recorded it, so I'm gonna post it on YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram.
Okay.
So as long as you follow me, you can get notified. Oh, let me take this. right, brothers. No, you want to say something to the people?
Absolutely. Randy, cheer. It was wonderful. Enjoyed every minute of it.
All right, Randy, man, nice to meet you. Man, you follow me on social media?
I will. I mean, I got to find you now. Where do I find
it? COVID Kemp. Instagram.
Oh, I took your picture. Look, wait.
Yeah.
Excuse me, it's all wrong. So, like, is it under social media under, with this?
No, Instagram, COVID Kemp.
Okay. Yeah, 10:30. Let's see here.
Would love to see you guys. Thank you.
All you gotta do is just put in, yeah.
Right there?
That should be, yeah, that should be. Yep, that's it.
Right here. All right, I'm gonna follow it.
All right, man.
Follow.
Man, appreciate right. You coming out, man.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, fella. You got something you wanna say to the people?
Man, I wish it was longer, I will say that.
It's gonna get longer. I might get back up there again.
Yeah, we gotta get you guys on
here. Yeah. If y'all know any friends, man, you know some friends. Bring them out to this place more often. Y'all follow me on Instagram, then y'all will see. Yeah, there you go, yeah. You one of the few who will get it right. Most people say Poetic Pimp or Poet the Pimp. It's like a pimp named Slickback, you gotta say it right. Yeah.
So that was excellent. All burning bridges were very pertinent, especially for us.
Oh,
yeah. Really good. I was taking some notes, but that's okay.
Remember, we're
speaking the same language.
Yeah. Okay. Well, as long as you follow me, too, you will see that video, and you can look at it, listen to it in your car or whatever, over and over and over again, and help you burn some bridges and build some.
We burned plenty.
Yeah, but build view. Well, fellas, it was nice to meet y'all, man. Hopefully y'all stick around or leave and come back. But if not, y'all get home safe.
Thank you. Well, thank you.
All right. Peace. Yeah. Peace, poetry, and pimping. Yeah.
one did they go through my feet?
Okay, you added me?
Yeah.